I don't believe what I just saw. I don't believe what I'm hearing. Look at this. Flowers all over Oscar's trash can. And a nice clean white picket fence. And a doormat? Do you know what it says on this doormat? It says, "Welcome." I have to find out what's going on. It's got a doorbell here and all this nice music.
Yes, just a moment, please. I'll be right there.
I think I'm gonna faint. Oscar just said, please.
Yes, may I help you? Oh, it's just you. Wait a minute, let me turn off the stereo sound here. No sense in wasting the music on you.
Mm-hmm.
What do you want?
I knew it was too good to be true.
Yeah.
Oscar, what is all of this beautifying of your can about?
You mean the flowers and everything?
Flowers, yes, and the tie. And your hair is combed.
Well, if it's any of your business there, which it isn't, I'm expecting some company from out of town.
Well, it must be somebody very special for you to go through all of this trouble.
Nah, he's not special. He's my brother.
I didn't know you had a brother.
Yeah, his name is Ernest, but I don't talk about him very much.
Well, how come?
Well, because he was my mother's favorite kid. He was always the one that was getting in trouble. She was always yelling at him and sending him to bed without supper and telling him he was rotten. Didn't tell me that. Well, I'm gonna get even with him. I've invited him here for a visit, and he thinks I'm gonna put lots of extra rocks in the guest bed and put chocolate sauce on his pickles. But I'm not. I'm gonna be nice and do all the yucky things that grouches hate most.
Well, this is certainly all the things that grouches hate most.
Right. Yeah, I'm gonna make him so comfortable and be so sweet and nice to him, he won't be able to stand it. Yeah, old Ernest is in for a surprise,
mm-hmm.
But there is just one trouble.
What's that?
I can't stand it here either. Okay, now don't bother me. I got work to do. I'm making a nice salad for old Ernest's lunch. He'll hate it.
Oscar's gonna try to be nice. This I've got to see. I can't wait till Ernest gets here. So Oscar's so mad at his brother, he's gonna try to be nice to him. Can you believe it?
No. What? Is this the place?
Hey there, hey, you. How's about one of you citizens directing me to the can of Oscar the Grouch and be quick about it? What do you say, huh?
Let me guess, you must be Oscar's brother, Ernest.
Hey, congratulations there, Ms. Wise Guy. You just won yourself a refrigerator. Now, if you'll guess the way to Oscar's can for me, I'll throw in an electric coat hanger and a free trip to Kalamazoo. How's the batter? What do you say, huh?
Well, that's Oscar's trash can right there. He lives there.
Oh, you're a pal. Hey, what's this? Picket fence around the place and flowers all over the joint? In a welcome mat? No grouch I know of does stuff like that. Hey, Oscar, you in there or what?
Coming. Oh, good. It's you, my dear brother Ernest. Oh, how nice it is to see you. Why, let me look at you. Aren't you a sight for sore eyes, dear brother?
What are you saying there, huh?
Oh, let me take your suitcase. Why, come right into your cozy little room. Come on, you'll want to wash up before lunch. We're having a lovely salad with lots of fresh tomatoes and lettuce. So come along, brother dear. And if you don't mind, please wipe your feet before you mess up the clean trash can. I'll bet he's feeling sick already.
I feel sick. Lettuce and tomatoes. Yeah. Wipe your feet. What? Hey. He's trying to be nice to me. That's it. He's trying to be nice to me because I was always the favorite kid in the family and he wants to get even. I'll fix him. I'll be nice and polite right back to him. I'll even be nicer than him. Oscar, I'll be right there as soon as I wipe my feet and take another sniff of these beautiful flowers. Hey, Oscar, this is a really nice place you got here. So clean and neat. I'm gonna like it here. Thanks for inviting me.
Huh? What are you telling me? I'm so glad, Ernest.
Can you imagine that? Two grouches being nice to each other. They're gonna try and outdo each other. Hey, but how can two grouches be nice to each other?
Well, Ernest, how did you like your lunch there? Did you enjoy the nice fresh tomatoes and lettuce?
Delicious, Oscar. I loved every bit of it.
I will say, how did you like your room there with the nice big soft fluffy pillows and the pink sheets with the little bunnies on them, huh?
You're so kind and thoughtful, Oscar. I just can't say thank you enough.
Yeah, you did. Well, don't mention it there, Ernest, dear brother. After all, you're my precious brother. It makes me so happy to be nice to you.
Yucky.
What did you say there, brother dear?
I said I was lucky to have such a wonderful, sweet, good-natured brother like you, Oscar. You're the nicest brother in the world.
This isn't working right. Say, Ernest, now that we've had lunch, why don't we go up on the veranda and get some nice, fresh air?
Yeah, that sounds delightful, Oscar.
Well, I'll go first here and hold the lid for you. Come along. Oh, this is terrible. He's being too nice and yucky right back to me. Come along, dear brother, come along. I have some wonderful ideas of things to do that you'll just love.
Hello. Look what we got here. Three of these things. We're going to play the game now. Join me, huh? Right? We have these circles
Look, Mr. Hooper.
Yes?
I want you to meet my brother here. He's visiting from out of town, and I'm taking him around so he can make friends with everyone here on Sesame Street. Ernest, this is Mr. Hooper. Mr. Hooper, this is my dear brother Ernest, who I don't see for years at a time. More's the pity. Boy, I hate saying things like that.
Hello,
make
Ernest.
Old Ernest squirm.
Yeah, Mr. Hooper. Yeah, Oscar told me all about you. Yeah, he says you're one of the nicest people he's ever met. He says you're one of his best friends. As a matter of fact, he really likes you a lot.
Well, that's very nice to hear. Thank you, Oscar.
This is killing me.
And it's a pleasure to meet you, Ernest.
A pleasure, he says. Yeah.
Well, let's go back to playing the game, right?
Oh, well, couldn't my dear brother Ernest and I play the game, too? We love playing games, don't we, Ernest, huh? Don't we love little kid games?
Oh, yeah, of course, dear brother. Yeah. Especially games that's got circles and squares in them.
I love circles and squares.
Fucking sick.
Grouches playing games? All right, join me. Let's go.
Get ready to sing, Ernest.
Three of these things belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same. But one of these things just doesn't belong here. Now it's time to play a game.
Time to play a game. Well, what do you say?
Oh, wait. Since Ernest here is our guest on Sesame Street, why don't we have Ernest explain the game? Tell us what is the answer, huh?
No, dear brother of mine. No, in deference to your charming hospitality, I insist that you go first and explain the game.
What? No. You do it.
No, you...
Why don't you do it, Mr. Hooper?
Yeah, good idea.
Thank you, Grouches. Mm. All right. Here we have three circles. One, two, three, and one square. That which doesn't belong is the square. Right?
So. Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Yeah, that's real swell there, Mr. Hooper. Real swell, yeah. Hey, listen. Because my brother's such a splendid person, and because he plays this game so very well, how's about my buying him an ice cream soda with extra whipped cream?
An ice cream soda with extra whipped cream? What's happening on Sesame Street? Grouches playing games, eating ice cream and sodas?
Look, dear brother Ernest, why don't you come down to my nice little trash can and we can play with this nice little kiddies who live in the neighborhood here.
Why don't we skip the social amenities, dear brother of mine, and get right down to remembering our dear sweet childhood.
Oh, yeah, that.
Like the time I broke the thing and you...
You know, I'm kind of worried about those two guys.
Yeah, this thing about being nice to each other, I think it's getting to them.
If they're not acting the way they really want to act, they must feel rotten inside.
They must. They could be having a good time, too, but they're so stubborn.
They're making me nervous. Come on, I got an idea.
What? Yeah, well, the time you broke the china cabinet and I got the blame.
Yeah, well, you always have all the luck.
A nice time.
Oh, yeah, we're having a wonderful time, right, dear brother?
Charming.
Hey, Mr. Hooper.
Can you mix up some peanut butter and ketchup?
And some pickles and sauerkraut. Huh?
Here it is. Peanut butter. Pickles, sauerkraut, and...
Ketchup.
All
right.
Yeah, look at the beautiful, beautiful sky today. Look at the little puffy white clouds.
And the lovely sun that makes your beautiful flowers grow.
Fellas, yeah? I have a lovely present for you.
Present. Oh, a lovely present, you say. Well, why don't you just give it to my brother there? He loves lovely presents, huh? Uh-huh. You have the honor of opening it.
No, my dear brother. I insist that you open it first.
No. You're my guest. I'd rather you have the pleasure.
Oh, no, dear brother. I insist. You take the present.
All it is peanut butter and ketchup
and pickles and sauerkraut all mixed up together.
Hey, give me that thing.
Hey, wait, get your mitts off of there. That's for me.
That's peanut butter and ketchup and pickles and sauerkraut.
Are you kidding? Don't yell at me, muttonhead.
Muttonhead? Listen, toad breath.
Cabbage head, take your hands off of that. It's for me.
Wait a minute, you're breaking the package.
I break your
Maria,
head.
That was a great idea. Everything is back to normal on Sesame Street.
The smartest, cutest one.
Gee, I hope we didn't make a mistake.
I'll turn you inside out.
Hey, that peanut butter, pickles, ketchup, and sauerkraut was really great.
Yeah, sure was. Except you had more than I did.
Of course I did. I should have had more. You were nicer than I was.
Me? I was not. You were nicer than I ever was.
No way, Flea Brain. You're really good at being nice. You know all about it.
What are you talking about? I couldn't be as nice as you in a million years. Take that.
Oh, yeah.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G and Q, and by the number 8.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.